All right, you guys ready? How about a nod, head nod? Yeah. Okay, thank you, Nikki. I see you, Charles, Pope. All right. All right, here we go. I'm going to adjust this. This is my home office. I live in Seattle. So I wanted to show you something I've been working on. I've actually been creating illusions now that, you know, we've got so much time home. And this is one of my favorite tricks lately. It's called the cut and restored rope trick, but I do it in a little different way. I'll show you what I mean. Got a piece of rope, and obviously people are gonna assume I've got some magnets or something on the rope, right? So I'm gonna pull it apart because I feel like if there's any engineers out there, you would know that if there's a magnet there, it would probably just yank right off. So give the rope a good tug. Solid piece of rope, nothing tricky about the ends right there. You can see that, and both of them right there. Okay, here we go. Cut and restore rope trick. And as you can imagine, I'm gonna use some scissors. So I've got my trusty Cutco scissors here, very sharp. So I'm just gonna go ahead, give it a cut. Right there. Now you probably heard that, right? Yeah? You can see that it's cut. You know, I'm looking at this. I wanted to do a better job of cutting it. They're not quite even. So, you know what? I'll tell you what. We're gonna have to start over with this. Okay? We're gonna start over. Yeah? You like that? Well, I can see that. Thank you, Martho Man. Is that how you say it? So here we go. I'm gonna start over. In fact, I'm gonna ask somebody to unmute themselves. How about Nikki, would you unmute yourself, please? Can you do that? Nikki Asko?
Sure can. Hi.
Hi. Thanks for doing this. Do you know what happens when you take the ends off a piece of rope?
They fray.
Yeah, right? They would fray, but when I take them off, they actually come right off. I'll put them in my pocket, but you end up with a loop, right?
No, not usually.
Not usually. Well, I guess during the magic show. You know what? That doesn't make much sense. So I'm going to just start over. We'll start over here. They'll just slowly melt back together. There we go. All right. You know what? I'm going to tie it this time. I thought I saw a kid in here. Oh, is it Kyle? Kyle, you got a kid there? She's got dark hair. Kyle, can you hear us? Oh. Yeah.
We're here.
Oh, can you unmute? Oh, there you go. Awesome.
There you go.
What's your name?
This is Serafina.
Serafina, awesome. I need some fake scissors from you. Hopefully they look like this.
Over by the camera
fake
here.
Fake scissors that look like this. All right, cool. Don't cut just yet, okay? Cut on three. We're gonna count to three. Serafina's gonna cut. Ready? One, two, three. What? Nicely done, Serafina.
You cut the rope, bro.
Two pieces. Of course, they're tied together, but I'm actually kind of surprised. You did a fantastic job. That's almost exactly even, but they're tied together. But you know what? Let's do this, Serafina. It is a magic show, and well, that's your cutting. I'm just going to move the knot.
What?
Yeah.
We'll move
you know this one?
And then you know what? Let's just take it off. We don't need the knot.
What?
Dad, I know the secret.
Are you sure?
Yes, I know.
All right, cool. You know what, we'll do it again. And I can assume, like, some people think I didn't really cut it. So look, I'll pull it apart. Like I said, cut and restore rope trick. So this time I'm gonna total that we're cutting the rope with scissors. Again, nice and close, you can see right there. Cut the rope, right? Okay. Shoot, look at this. Again, I made a mistake again. Look how, that's not even. Okay, you know what? We're just gonna have to start over again. I apologize. We'll do the cut and restore rope trick. Sound good? All right. In fact, this is my favorite part. Here are the ends, here's the center. Check this out. I'll take the ends, I'll put them in my pocket right here. Now watch this, I'll do this on three. Ready? One, two, three. You see that? Well, if there's one in there, there's another one over there. Well, if the ends are here, and in my pocket is the middle.
What?
Of course, that's the cut and restore rope trick. I really hope you enjoyed that. Thank you very much. Thank you so much. You guys are awesome. Great, thank you. Now, I've been at Mirabella. I don't know how long many of you have been there, but I've been, I've had the privilege of performing in the large room on the big stage at Mirabella over the years. Leslie, you've asked me to work with you a couple of times, so I appreciate that. But I try to reinvent myself and do new tricks along the way. And so you're going to see pretty much a new show if you've seen me before. I think I've been at Mirabella maybe 5 times in the last 10 years, okay? Now, one of the things I wanted to tell you is, like I said, we've all got a lot of time on our hands doing projects. I planted seed in the lawn. I've literally been watching the grass grow. Yeah, okay? I've also cleaned out my closet, and I found some really old things that I've been holding on to. For instance, this is my lucky piece of paper. It's got a paper clip on it. I don't want to go into what it is. Maybe it will come about later, maybe not. And then also here, this is a marked deck of cards. It's not a normal deck. It's, well, it's a normal deck, but it's marked because I marked it myself. I'll tell you about that in a little bit, but I'm going to put these in this box and I'm going to leave it over here on my table, okay? We'll see what happens with this later on. Okay, now I want to do some good old fashioned sleight of hand. Would you guys like to see some sleight of hand? Yeah?
Sure, okay. Yeah.
Cool, thank you for that. All right, it's good to hear the cute voices. I've got 3 kids here at home, so well, hopefully you won't hear them. All right, now this is, let's see, I'm gonna ask Susan Cohn, that camera. Yeah, can you unmute yourself, please, guys? Hey, bud, what's your name?
What's your name?
Isaac.
Isaac? Mm-hmm. Nice to meet you. Do you know what this is right here, bud? What is that?
Marble.
Oh. It looks like a marble.
It looks, oh yeah, it does look like a marble from your view.
Show it sideways. Show it sideways. Yeah, there we go.
There we go.
A coin.
A coin, you're absolutely right. That is a penny, and you can actually do magic with a penny. It doesn't make any sense, but I'll show you what I mean. Look, if you take a magnifying glass, I figured this out the other day. Take a magnifying glass, it makes things look bigger, right? Like, look at my eye. Look how big that looks, right? Kind of weird. But I figured I could make more money, which I could definitely, let's see, let's get the lighting right. I could make more money if I put the coin or the magnifying glass over the coin. You see how much bigger that looks? Imagine if I did it on a 50. It would look bigger, but it wouldn't be worth more. But look, did you see that? It makes it a permanent process.
Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, either my head is super small or this is a gigantic penny. Right? Well, thank you, Harry. I appreciate the round of applause. Great. Thank you.
It's like a quarter.
I know. It is bigger than a quarter. But here, I'll tell you what. Here's the fun thing. If I take the coin, I can put it over there. It actually vanishes totally. Yeah, gone. But look, if I just wave like this and it just comes back like that. Of course, it is a normal coin. You can see it's got Abraham Lincoln on there. But if I blow on it, you see that? Oh my gosh. Look how big that is. That's huge. And it's worth 1 cent. Yeah. But this is the cool part is, even though it's super big, well, it doesn't work in vending machines, but I can take it there. And if I rub it just right, it vanishes. It actually comes out of my elbow. Yeah. That's why I'm wearing a short shirt here, because you can see I've got no pockets or sleeves. But look, I'll do this again. Look, I'll put it right there. See, it vanishes, or at least it gives it the illusion that it's there. Oops, sorry. Here, we'll do it again. I'll take it, vanishes, gives it the illusion that it's gone, but it's actually there. I just have to reappear. See, it's a rubber coin. That's how it works. Rubber. Well, that's a total joke. It's actually solid metal. You can hear that. Not worth anything more than a penny, but thank you. I hope you enjoyed that. Thank you. Now, do you guys remember the marked deck of cards? Would you like to see something with a marked deck? And yeah, I know this sounds really weird, but I'm gonna show you. I'll get it. It's over here for a second. I'll leave my lucky paper there. Get to that later. This is my marked deck. I made it myself with a Sharpie right there across the board, or the tops of it, or the edges. Okay, bring this real close so you can see. You see those markings right there? It's like a barcode. But also, it's a shuffled marked deck, okay? You see that? All the cards are already shuffled. So we're gonna do an interactive trick with a marked deck over the internet here, and somebody's gonna help me out. A shuffled marked deck, okay? I'm gonna go to, how about Nancy? Nancy Lute? Okay, would you mind unmuting your camera, please, or your microphone? Okay, so Nancy, you're gonna help me out. Just tell me when to stop. I'll thumb through the cards. You say stop anytime, and whatever card you say stop on will be yours, okay?
Okay.
All right, say stop, Nancy.
Stop.
Oh, we'll do it a little bit. I'll go fast, I'll go slower, you go faster, ready?
Okay, stop.
Oh, we'll do it again.
Stop.
Oh, how about on the count of three? One, two, three.
Stop.
Nancy, I totally messed with you, okay? All right. We all need more fun in our days, right? Here, for real this time, I'll go nice and slow. You just say stop, please.
Stop.
Oh, wait, hold on. I forgot. Shuffle deck, right? Okay. So yeah, you just say stop. I'll go nice and slow, okay? Here we go. Say stop.
Stop.
I'm going to show you the card, but I'm going to look away, okay? Don't, don't see it out loud, please.
Okay.
Yes or no for everybody in the room. Can you see that okay?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. See that one? Now I'm going to put it back and I'll look at the screen again, but it doesn't matter if I see the card. I've seen this trick quite a bit. Okay. So Nancy, shuffled. Rather than shuffling the cards to find yours, I'm going to give it an unshuffle. I know that doesn't make any sense. And you're probably thinking, what the heck is an unshuffle? Well, I will, I'll show you. I'm going to give the cards a mix. And you can see that they're being intertwined. But you see, if you look closely, you'll start to notice the markings.
Unshuffled.
They say a word. They say the word unshuffled on it four times. You see, Nancy, it represents the four suits, the clubs, the hearts, the spades, and the diamonds. I'm going to do this again, even though nobody is asking. Okay, yes. I heard it. I saw it from somebody. I'll do it again, okay?
Yes,
all right, thank you. All right, there we go. We'll do it again. You can see they're being intertwined again, completing the shuffle, squaring up the cards, and yet now it says the word unshuffled twice. You see, it's unshuffling the red cards from the black cards. We'll do it again. Wait. Nancy, for you, we still have to... I'll do another final unshuffle. Cut the cards at random, and there we go. Now the cards are completely unshuffled, Nancy.
Yes.
Does that say that correctly left to right? It's backwards for me. It does. Thank you, Carolyn. Okay. But you don't have to take my word for it. I'm saying it's unshuffled. The words, it says it unshuffled, but it really is unshuffled. Every single card is back in its original order, as if it was just opened from the box. There is not a single card out of place here. Everything is back in order.
Whoa.
Thank you.
Wait,
what? We wanted a card.
Now, oh, so demanding, Barbara. I think I can handle it.
Yeah.
Leslie, was that the lady you were talking about? No, I'm just kidding. All right, here we go. Ready?
Comment.
Here we go. You can see it's all shuffled. I'm trying to do this so you can see with the lighting. But I could find the card by just pulling it out. You know, that would be cheating, which is totally my MO. I am a magician after all. But let's do this. Barbara, for you, we still have to find her card. So why don't you all just think about Nancy's card, and we'll see what we can do. Hit the two of spades. We got it?
Wow.
The two of spades. Awesome. Round of applause for Nancy. Thank you. Woo. All right. Awesome. Well, thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Now, I'd like to do something more with some coins, and not a big penny, but some legitimate coins that we're all familiar with, and, well, 50 cent piece, right? You can see that right there? In fact, I've got three of them, and I'm going to do something right here on my table here. So I've got to get this set up. Because we're doing it close up, it's nice that I can do all this unique style of magic with everyone. And I've also got this pad. This is actually my practice pad. I use this at home for hours and hours on end. It just gives me a soft surface to deal with the cards. And I'll show you, when you do have a soft surface, you're able to do, well, pretty cool stuff, manipulating the cards. You can do fancy table shuffles. Oh, there we go. You can just pick them all up. And then you can go back to this and even do a little bit of that. You get what I mean? All right. So now that we have the soft surface, I'm gonna bring this real close, get the camera down as much as I can. And we will do this with three coins. Three coins, so you can see everything, okay? Three coins. Now, here we go. One, two, three. I'm gonna use Harry for this, okay? Is that your name or is that just the camera's name?
It's my nickname.
Your nickname. I'll call you Harry, okay? Harry, how many coins do we have?
Three.
Three, awesome. Now my hands, my sleeves are rolled up, it's and my fingers, hard. Not my trick fingers, well, except for that one. Okay. Just kidding, Harry. Look, more dad jokes. Huh? Magic. No, I'm just kidding. All right, those are for the dads out there, okay? All right, Harry. Watch, you said three coins. I think you're absolutely right, but watch. Even if I cover them up, how many coins would you say I have?
I know you're gonna duplicate or get rid of them.
How many coins would you say I have?
You can never know with a magician.
Right. Tell you what, I'll help you out, Harry. I have three coins. I'm just trying to mess with you because you know I'm gonna mess with anyways, here we go. There, I'll put them like that so they're touching, but watch, it's gonna happen on three, okay? Watch, one, two, three. Did you see it go? Vanishes from here, and I just put it over there. Whoa. Now look, we'll do it again, and I know you might be thinking like, oh, he did something fast, there's something wrong or something crazy with the table. That's why I tried to prove it's legitimate. Earlier, but you could literally be right here, inches away, and I could still do this. But Harry, how many coins? We'll do it again. How many coins are under here?
Logic says there'd be two.
You're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. And there is two, okay? But look, I'll do it again. Watch. One, two, and three. Mm-hmm. Harry, I'll do it again. Would you like to see the third and final coin go from here to there? But it's your choice. Do you want to see it go from here to there, visibly or invisibly?
What do you mean by that? Do you mean literally moving over or?
You want to do, well, we've done it invisible twice. Do you want to see it, me do it invisibly again, or do you want to see it go from here to there?
Whichever one is easier.
How about Martha Mann? What would you like to see? Visibly or invisibly?
Let's do visibly this time.
Okay, visibly, that's fair. Okay, ready? Do, 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 do. Okay. Would you like to see it go invisibly this time?
Sure.
Okay, invisibly, watch. It happens fast. One, two, three. Gone. But look, it's there. I know it doesn't look like it, but it is there. It looks like two coins, but the third one is on top. It's invisible. But if I snap, give it a shake, it makes itself visible. And that is all three coins. And there we go. No, I'm just kidding, over here. I hope you like that. how do you think we're doing, Leslie? Is that able to transcend over the internet?
You're doing just fine.
Good, good, good.
Back row and Emerald Hall didn't see any of this.
Yeah, I know, I know. So I was actually excited about today's show because I traditionally do my usual repertoire, but for Mirabella, I get to throw in my new classics that I have learned for years, so and I haven't done for years. Now, I'm gonna have somebody else help me out. Charles Pope, or the gal next to you in the I'm gonna use Charles. Okay, hi sir, would you mind taking your camera off mute or your microphone? Thank you, welcome. You having a good day?
You.
Okay, yes. I'll use the gal, the lovely assistant. I can't turn one down. How are you doing, miss?
Fine.
Good, good, good. Now, we're gonna do a card trick, one more card trick for the whole group, and I was hoping you could help me out. What's your name?
Joe.
Joe, okay, thanks, Joe. And you look familiar. Have I seen you in the hall before? Have you seen one of my shows?
Absolutely.
Okay, yeah. I thought so. Good to see you again. All right. Now, Joe, in a moment, I'm gonna have you think of a card, but not yet. Okay, you gotta just think of a random card. But keep in mind, I've read up on this. I've looked at studies by psychologists and magicians who are also psychologists. And we know, statistically speaking, if I were to ask all the ladies in this Zoom room, most of them would choose the Queen of Hearts if they were to choose a card in their mind. If I were to ask all the gentlemen, they would probably choose the Ace of Spades. Not all of them, but statistically speaking, you can get like overwhelming odds, like 75%. But those are just the studies. Everybody is different, okay? So you can think of any card you want, but not yet. First, I wanna bring something into this picture. We're gonna do this trick not with one deck of cards. Not with just one. Not with two. Not with three. Four or five. We're actually gonna do this deck, this trick, with a bunch of cards, a bunch of decks. We're gonna do this trick with 52 decks. Because, Joe, there are 52 cards in a deck. All right? Now, a little factoid I'd like to share with you all is there's 52 cards in a deck. Maybe some of you can correlate that to there are 52 weeks in a year, right? There's also four suits. There's four seasons. And if you were to add up the values of all the cards, like the ace would be one, the 11, or the jack would be 11, it equates to 365 days in a year. Kind of interesting. There's more parallels there, but I just think that's more interesting. Not part of this illusion. I just wanted to share it with you. So Joe, in each one of these decks that has 52 cards, I've taken the liberty, it took me a while, but I went through each deck and I turned over one card in each of these decks. So I'm gonna try and do that with the lighting. It's fair to say that there's a different card turned over in each of the decks, which total 52 different cards, one deck. So in this deck, it has the Three of Spades turned over. Okay. So definitely don't think of the Three of Spades because we know it's in this deck. But Joe, I'll put this aside. Would you please think of a card right now? Put one in your mind, commit it to memory. Do not tell Charles next to you, please. Do you have one in your mind? Now, Joe, I'm gonna have you choose a pile. There's four piles, four seasons. Here we go. One, two, three, or four. I will not change this order, but pile one, two, or three, or four. Oh. Give me a pile number, please.
Three,
that would be this one. You wanna stick with this one?
Yeah.
Okay. Very carefully, I'm gonna remove pile four. I don't want you to think I'm doing any tricky things going on pile two. And pile one. So you've chosen pile three, which is this right here. And we'll divide this into three more piles. Joe, one, two, or three, it's your choice. Give me a number, please.
Three,
that would be this one.
Yep.
Would you like to change your mind?
No.
Are you sure? But before you answer, nobody ever does. They always stick to their decision. Would you like to change your mind?
No.
Okay. You guys see what I mean? Nobody changes their mind. I tried. I'll take pile one and pile two and we'll put it away. So here we go, Joe. Pile one or two?
One.
That's this one right there. You know you can change your mind, but she won't. Okay. We'll do this. Red or blue? You tell me.
Red.
Red, that's this one. Okay, here we go. This will not leave your sight, but Joe, I'm not going to open this up. But there is or should be one card turned over facing the other way in this deck. For everyone to hear, Joe, for the first time, please tell us all, what is the card that you've been thinking of? What is it?
Seven of clubs.
Seven of clubs. Are you guys ready for this? We'll see if she got it right. If she didn't, don't blame me, okay? I'm gonna go through it. But look, the card is right there on top. I'll bring it nice and close. Can you see that? One card turned over. Out of all these cards, you see that?
Yes.
And I'll take it.
Oh,
woohoo! That's quite amazing.
Nice job. I don't even want to talk about the odds of that happening.
Good job, Joe.
Yes, a huge round of applause for Joe, everybody. Let's give it to him. Yes. Very good. Thank you very much. Thanks for helping me out. Me. Now, I'd like to show you something. I'd like to teach you all a magic trick. Would you all like to learn a magic trick today? Yeah? This can be done with hair barrettes, like hair ties, ladies, if you have them, or a rubber bands about this size. Now, first I'll perform it for you, and then I'm going to teach you the secret, okay? Because the first time I do this, people think they're trick rubber bands. But watch. I'll take the rubber band, place it on my two fingers, okay? Now, if I just give it a blow, watch, one, two, three, it jumps to the other side. I'll do it again, watch, one, two, three, it jumps. Now, look, I'll take the second rubber band and put it around there, therefore creating a barricade. It cannot get through. It's stuck, right? But look, I'll do it again. Watch. One, two, three. It still jumps. I'll do it again. One, two, three.
Wow.
Quite the conundrum, right? Are you ready to see the secret? Harry's got a guess, I can tell, but I'm going to go ahead and show everybody.
This is a question.
Oh, what's your question, bud?
Can you do that trick except instead of putting your hand on like that, you can do it like that?
Oh, could I? Well, you're about to find out because I'm going to tell you the secret. It's a great question. Now, your mind is telling you that the rubber band is coming off like that and back on like that. That's what our minds are telling us, which as far as I know is impossible. What's really happening is the rubber band is flipping over like this, just flipping over, okay? So how that happens is backstage, I actually pull this down like that. I create that space right there. I put my fingers inside there and then kind of move it like that so they all fit and then I let it rest there. But this is what everybody else sees. So as I lift my fingers up, they actually scoop that rubber band up and over. I'll do it again. I go like this, I do that, leave it there, and then I flip, scooping it up and over. Now here's the thing with the other rubber band. Remember this? Impossible, right? But look, same thing. It just goes over like that. So if I do this, same thing as before, it feels a little awkward, but pull this down, put them all in there, flip it up, same.
Still magic.
Then, if you take the rubber bands, same ones, and you kind of just put them together, like they're locked, they're secure. Of course, I can't teach you everything, but they can't get through either way, but if you blow on it, they rub, they just penetrate through. I'm gonna do that again, look. They go through. You see how they're locked? They're intertwined. We'll do this again. They're locked. They can't get through either way, even that way or this way. But look, they just kind of melt together, melt through. Okay. That one's weird. I don't even get that one. We have time for one more. Would you guys like to see one more?
One more.
Okay, I'm gonna turn off my lights here, because we're gonna do something unique here, and I'm gonna go backstage here, and I'm gonna ask some people to help me out. So I'm gonna ask, let's see, Susie, Nikki, Makiko, and Jean, and Askov. Can you all put your microphones on, please? Dick, I'm gonna use you as well, sir.
Okay.
Okay, we're gonna start with Susie Pedal. Are you able to put your microphone? It's not it. We'll go to the next person. Nikki Askov, can you give me a number, please, between 1 and 100, one or two digits?
Six.
Now, I forgot to mention, it has to mean something to you. Does the number 6 mean something to you, or it does?
Good. My favorite number.
All right, cool. I'm gonna write that down here for you. Okay, and I'll put a little circle around it. I'm gonna go next, Askov, MacBook Air. Can you give me a number, please, sir?
7.
7. Now, you know these are 1 in 100 people, okay? Okay, now we're gonna go to Makiko. Can you give me a number, please? It looks like you're on mute. A 1 or 2-digit number. Are you able to turn your microphone on? All right, we'll come back to you if you get that. Jean, can you give me a number, please?
Left corner.
Let's see, Jean Hall. Oh, I'm sorry. 52. Oh, there you go. 52, all right. 52, says Jean, all right. And then we're gonna go to Dick, sir. Can you give me a number?
30.
Dick Fike, thank you. 33, he says. I'll write that right there. And then back over, let's see, Makiko, what do you have for your number?
Oh, I say 8.
8, I like it. Okay, we're gonna do 8 right here. And I wanna get one more number 8. And then we'll go to, let's see, Louise, would you please help me out, miss? Louise Lowry? Can you take your microphone? There you go. A number between 1 and 100, please.
88.
Did you say 88?
I did.
88.
88,
right?
88. Right.
All right. Okay, 8 and 88. I like it. Lots of 8s here. Okay, so I wanted to ask everybody if that meant something to anybody. Makiko, does that mean anything to you, these set of numbers here?
Oh, I liked 7, but I had to say 8, so it doesn't mean anything to me.
Okay, Dick, the number 33, I don't think you said that, but is that your age?
No.
It's hard to tell, it's dark in there, I'm just assuming.
I did say 33, yes.
You did, okay. Does this whole set, oh my gosh, Nikki, is this your credit card number?
I hope not.
Dick and I are gonna go shopping if it is. All right. Oh, I wonder, does the total possibly add up to something crazy? Let's try it. I'll add it together on my phone here. 6 plus 7 plus 52 plus 33 plus 8 plus 88 equals 194. Does that mean anything to anybody? 194.
Oh.
Okay. Jean, I am drowning over here. Does this mean something to you? It does. It's not the total. Is this your phone number?
No, not really. No.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I hope the last trick was good because this is kind of a train wreck. Wait, I almost forgot. Remember, we did the Mark deck of cards out of the box, but from the beginning of the show, there's one more thing in there. The piece of paper with the paper clip, remember? My lucky paper. Hold on. I'm just gonna do this. I just wanna show you. I mean, there's nothing crazy. It's been in view the whole time.
Oh, no.
But look, you see that? right there, the paper. I'm going to take that out. It will not leave your sight. Okay. I'm going to take off the paper clip. It's folded up. It's a lotto ticket. Yeah, it's a Powerball ticket from when I was traveling in California about 2016. It's September 14th, 2016. But you guys, here's what's crazy. Look at the numbers. The Powerball numbers. 6, 7, 8, 33, 52. And the Powerball number right there is 88. You guys, that's the end of my show. I hope you missed. That is the lotto ticket. And you guys were awesome. Thank you, Mirabella.